Hey everybody, Mickey here with a Trials of Mana Beginner's Guide. This is a really solid, fun game. It really harkens back to the old school golden age of JRPGs. There's some things that I would have appreciated knowing during my first playthrough of Trials of Mana, so hopefully this beginner's guide can give you some direction for the first 8 to 10 hours or so. Now, if you're confused about what party to start the game with, I've created a guide that you can check out to help you out with that. This video is more geared towards general tips that'll help you throughout the game. Let's first talk about leveling up and money. You've probably noticed a bonus experience that's given in battles that you've fought, and you'll want to take advantage of these. There's a bonus for taking out enemies quickly in 10 seconds, 20 seconds, and 30 seconds respectively, but the best bonus in my opinion is when you finish a battle without taking any damage, which gives a 10% bonus. This should be your primary goal in nearly every battle, which is easier said than done and kind of becomes situational because there's some battles where you just have too many enemies that you're just not going to be able to dodge. But the point of the matter is that you want to try to complete battles without taking damage in order to boost the experience that you receive. When it comes to money, the only real tip that I can give is to sell your unnecessary gear. Whether it's equipment or items that you don't use, just go ahead and sell them off. There's no real penalty for doing so. There's of course these gold orbs that are all around the world that you can pick up, which often give money, and I suggest picking those up when you can. But you'll be given a ton of different items that you may not even use, so don't be afraid to sell them for money, which will become a bit more difficult to come by as weapons and equipment start to drastically rise in price about mid-game. Now there are items that you can use in order to boost the experience that you obtain as well as the money, I think it's called Lucre, but I'll get into those items in a little bit here. Use these items at your own discretion, there's no set in stone rule as to when to use them. So for instance, the experience cookies, I'm going to be saving those for later in the game because leveling up is more difficult. But I might be using the incense in order to get more money because of the fact that maybe I'm running low on money. So I just figured I'd let you guys know there are items that can boost the experience and money that you get per battle. And you'll get those items most often from item seeds. You'll start collecting item seeds throughout your journey where you'll plant those at inns while over at villages. And when you plant these seeds, you'll be rewarded with items and sometimes gear. There's a whole ton of different items that you can get, but among them are things like permanent stat increases or experience boosting cookies or the item that you can use here to boost your money. When you plant these item seeds, your planter will level up. And the higher the level of your planter, the better items that you'll get. The highest level you can get your planter to is level 5. Now keep in mind there are different types of seeds as well. There are regular item seeds, silver seeds, gold seeds, question mark seeds, and rainbow seeds. For now, just to keep things simple, just plant the item and silver seeds normally. The gold, question mark, and rainbow seeds are for things that are more important. So you'll want to have a higher planter level before using these seeds because those seeds are more rare. A few hours into the game, you'll get to a village named Basir, which is known for its night market, where you can buy items that aren't available anywhere else. There's a couple of things to note about the night market. So there's this fortune teller here that will allow you to reset your training points. Does cost quite a bit of money, so only use this early in-game if you either have a ton of money or if you feel like you've really screwed up with how you've allocated your training points. I've got a guide on how to spend your training points in the early game, so you can check that video out if you'd like as well. Now, at the item store, you can buy various claws, coins, and eyes. And these type of items you want to keep in mind. These are essentially spells that you can cast just by using items. The reason why this is important is that when it becomes time to change your class, you'll want items that cover all your bases. And what I mean by that is to say that you have a character that can debuff by lowering the defense of an enemy. Well, you'll want to take advantage of that even more so by throwing an attack up on your melee damage dealer to do even more damage. So, in this case, you would buy the Drake Scale since it boosts attack. Or say you're fighting an enemy that's weak to wind, but you don't have a party member that can cast any wind-based spells. That's when you would go ahead and buy a Storm Coin or a Siren Claw to give your party member wind elemental damage. So just keep the Night Market at Bisir in mind, because the items that you can get here are extremely good, and you have the Fortune Teller that can go ahead and reset your training points if you need. This is a place that you'll be coming back to. Something else that will help you out are chain abilities, and you can only get chain abilities by talking to specific NPCs throughout your journey. Typically, these are going to be NPCs that have more interaction with the main cast of the game. So, for instance, at the very beginning of Duran's path, you'll fight a knight that acts as a tutorial for the battle system. Well, later on in Duran's path, you can meet up with that knight and obtain a chain ability from him. One final tip I have is to make sure you're actively looking for the cacti. So during your journey, you'll come across a cactus locating side quest that have some pretty excellent rewards. One of my favorite is the double experience reward. Doesn't really happen too often, but rarely your experience will double for one battle, provided that you've actually gotten all the cactus to unlock the reward. Point of the matter is that if you're diligent enough to find these cacti as much as possible, you'll be reaping the benefits sooner rather than later. Hopefully these tips can give you a little primer on what to expect during your playthrough of Trials of Mana. If this video was helpful to you at all, a like or a comment always really helps support the channel.